So we'll start our session about the assessment. And while we were circulating yesterday on the groups, we noticed that assessment was one of the aspects that needs improvement, right? So we will discuss today the assessment. A brainstorming exercise rapidly in 1 minute. Why do we assess our students?
To know where they are, to know what they need improvement in, to know the progress.
Maybe to understand what we need to improve, in, if there is something to be, needs to be improved. Check your progress.
Tarek.
Last comment?
What did you find out?
To assess ourselves in teaching.
I'm sorry?
Did you ask about another microphone?
Yeah, unless we didn't need it.
So, it is more than just grades or pass and fail. So our importance of assessment, the purpose of assessment, not just to let the student pass or fail. Okay, the learning objectives after this session, participant will be able to distinguish a learning goal from a learning objective. Use a backward design to align learning objectives with cognitive assessment. Analyze questions using Bloom's taxonomy and distinguish summative and formative assessments. And these are the learning objectives of this session. While you are designing your course in the faculty or the college, while you are working, or your course or your teaching units, so what did we do? First, we choose a textbook, and then create our syllabus, and then write and revise lecture and notes, prepare PowerPoint lecture presentation, and finally, the exam, right? Anyone do anything like that? All of us? Okay. This is called an instructor-centered approach. It is an instructor-centered approach. So, the backward design that we get you from today to the end of our workshop or institute, we'll start by developing your general goals. Your teaching unit should start with a general goal. What I want from this program, what I want from this course, okay? And then the measurable objectives and the summative assessments in form of the exam, and finally formative assessment in form of instructional methodology. So it is called a backward design, and actually what we will do, inshallah, from after the launch, will be developing your general goals and the measurable objective of your topics, and starting from tomorrow, you will, and Tuesday, you will make the summative assessment and the formative assessments. And this approach is called the learner-centered approach. So we are concentrating on the learner rather than the instructor. The goals of our workshop, and this is, these are the goals of the whole workshop, okay? To understand the important concepts of responsible conduct of research, to appreciate the potential of dual-use technology to be used for harmful purposes, to understand professionalism in science and know the role of scientists as part of a responsible scientific committee, to appreciate that learners come to a classroom with different backgrounds and experiences that impact their learning, and to learn new teaching techniques to deliver content about responsible conduct of research. And again, these are goals. So, we stated two slides previously, the objective of our session, and these are the goals of the workshop. Could you see the difference between goals and objectives?
I think that the goals should be a general information and not measurable, while the objective should be contain measurable data. Okay.
Any other comment?
Are these goals like a general headline for what you want to do, and then the objective is specific subcategories for the borderlines that we did?
I think I should have many objectives to reach to the final goal.
Okay.
I think if you cover the objectives, you will obtain the goal.
If we have one goal, we have several objectives. The objective should be defined by specific methodology and specific assessment method.
Thank you. You got it. So, goals are usually not measured. I cannot measure the understanding, cannot measure the appreciation, but objective should be measured. I should use words that are measurable. I can measure. Like use, so I can see what they are using, or graph, they write graphs like you did, and design. Okay? So goals are not measurable, although they are verbs that cannot be measured, while the objective should be verb also, but they are measured. Thank you. Let's see an example. The goal, we used this goal for the workshop. This was to learn new teaching techniques to deliver content about responsible conduct of research. And I think to obtain this goal, we have, like objectives, to use clicker and cards while in the classroom, which is teaching techniques, new teaching techniques, and at the same time it is an active learning, and to apply different interactive instructional methodology like group discussion, simulation, think, parent, chair. So, think, parent, chair. For each session, from today morning, we started, each session has a goal and list of objectives. Right? So, what is the importance of the objectives for the learning process? Why we use objectives? Why we have to write objectives in our backward design? Why we will start today using goals and objectives? So, we change the think along for 1 minute and then share your thought with your neighbor. And finally, discuss to the group, and this will be for 3 minutes, each 1 minute. Starting thinking only 1 minute, alone for 1 minute, about what is the importance of the objectives